Well, what you need to know is what the president, the vice president, the task force have been saying the last few days, which is that these new guidelines from the CDC will actually mitigate this health crisis for many and literally save lives. So we all can do our part by going to cdc.gov, coronavirus.gov, look at these guidelines. The president himself has tweeted them out. These are unprecedented times with this virus, but and it calls for unprecedented action. But we also know about the resilience and the strength and the fortitude of the American people. We know that we're a strong, unified nation who will help the elderly who can't get out for meals, for example. The USDA just approved the delivery of about roughly 1 million meals a week to rural-based students. I talked to Secretary Sonny Perdue at the USDA, and he, in fact, has this new email, feedingkids@usda.gov. That bill that the Senate will vote on today, that the House passed last week, does include billions of dollars for nutritional assistance for our vulnerable populations, pregnant women, women at the, and with children at the poverty line, seniors, children. It also includes billions of dollars for vaccines and for paid family leave. So there are, we can all do our best to mitigate the health consequences of this unprecedented virus, mm-hmm. but our government is working together and with the private sector to help mitigate the economic devastation as well.